Hi everyone, welcome again to our new topic of the Uipath, that is manage process automatically in Uipath. So in this session I will explain you how to manage already or the background process which is already running in your Windows system. So just like if you are taking any example of that, so when we launch any browser or any application, so there is definitely some processes are running in background. So how we can manage that processes, and it is very important when we are working with the Windows system or when we are working on the terminal part. So we want to know or we want to get all the details of the whatever all the processes are running. Sometimes it is creating in the memory, or size of the memory is also increases. Same thing also happen at the cloud system. So when we are working with the cloud and the Windows system, so it is very important to manage that processes running automatically. It is also required to monitor the useless processes which is already running. So that is also eating your memory space and slowing down your speed of activity. So that part of concern is always have in developer's mind to manage background processes automatically. So in this example I will explain you how to manage the Internet Explorer browser background processes, so that you will learn how to manage this. So let's begin with this. I have already created one script in UiPath, so it will launch to Internet Explorer, and every Internet Explorer browser should show up me a one pop-up message. So first pop-up message I will get it to kill some processes. After killing some of the processes, that browser will be not closed, means whatever processes are running which is not mandatory required for that browser, we are going to kill for first pop-up. When we are pressing on the second pop-up message, it will kill my whole application or it will close my browser. So let me run and show you the output. It's running, so it will launch to Internet Explorer browser, and then I will get pop message on top of that. Now you can see first browser is launched, again second one. Now first pop-up message, when I click on this, my browser is still in running process. Now you can see my browser is here. When I click on the second one, it will close my both the browser. So it is killing the application, which is done by killing the processes automatically. So now I will show you how to do that. So first we will need two variables. One is get process and second is end process. Get process will have a variable type of system.collection.objectModel.collection, and then this system at system.diagnostic.process. So this is my variable name with variable type. So end process will have boolean and the value by default is true. Now I drag to open browser activity, you can drag it from here. So to open browser activity, I have nothing written on that. It depends on your requirement. If you want to show up that google.com or any other website, or from your website name, that also you can do that. So I have just written here is the google.com, and google.com is same with other open browser activity. Next I dragged here for each process. So in for each process, the type of argument should be system.diagnostics.process, so that it will handle all the required processes or all the required activities or jobs to be handled for the process or for the terminal end process. In the value types, I provided here as a get process detail. Next, I dragged here the if condition. In if condition, we should have to mention process dot toString dot contains, and contains should always have function type. You can mention here the contains of. So once you will enter contains of, you will get the contains value as string as boolean. When you hover on that, you will get that these type of specification. And in the contain terminal, I have written here explore. So for the exploring the content of the browser. Next, I dragged here one sequence in then a block of if condition. Inside the sequence, I have dragged here one write line activity, and the main write line activity written is process.toString, because process is automatically created by data type data table type for the item, but here we want to convert it to .toString. Next, if condition I process dragged here for process.toString.contains, and here I have written inside the contains I have written I explore and end process. So again, the contains should always have function string and value as string or as a boolean. So by this way, this condition will be fulfilled. Now I've dragged here one sequence. Inside the sequence, I've dragged here one message box. So once my first browser will be launched, this message box should be populated on my screen. Next, drag here from the kill process activity. You can see here kill process activity, and in kill process activity, I've just mentioned here the name as a kill AI process, and the target type, inside the target type I've written here process, then value is again process. Now next activity we need inside the second if condition, assign. So assign should always have end process equal to false. So this is my 2 and this is my value is false. At the end of the code, we want one message to box to be appeared for the second browser, and I did not written anything else here, just written the name all the I browser process will be killed. Next to this, I have dragged here again kill process for killing second application, but make sure we have to mention here I explore, because in contains field we have already provided I explore. And you can see here for the first we have written here the process. So now it is completed our complete script, and I have already shown you the output of that flowchart. So hope you understand it. If you have any queries or comment, please comment in the comment box so that I will check and reward you the resolution. And don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.